wondering, what is your favorite books out of the Mortal Instruments?
Again, I think I'm going to have to go kind of with what Cassie said. For me, the first film and the first, well, first film, as if there's already going to be a second one. The first book, I think, for me, it's great to see Clary at the beginning and to see how she matures and how she ages and how she really fights for herself and grows into this young woman, even by the end of the book. And then, obviously, she goes off and has this complete growth and adventure in the whole series. But I think in the first one, you get to see that first inkling of what she's capable of. And it's that first time that she meets all the characters, and it's that first introduction as an audience into this magical world that Cassandra's created. And that's kind of that jaw-dropping moment when you first see past a glimmer, or when you first meet Jace, and you are like Clary, when you're like, oh my gosh, who is this guy? You know? And I think it's that first entrance into the world that always, like, captures you. And so from then on, obviously, it takes you on highs and lows, and it's exciting, but I think the first one is always the most special to me, so I'd have to say this one. And please send my love to her. Go SMT.
Hi, Cassandra. I was wondering, how is it to see your book and then turn into a movie? Like, how was that experience,
watching the process and these characters come to, like, flesh and life?
It was amazing. I mean, it's a long process of, like, casting and getting the screenplay and all of that work, you know, and it was interesting, it was very collaborative. I worked with the producers, and I talked with Harald, and we talked with Lily, and we talked with the other actors, you know, throughout the whole casting process to kind of get, like, a team of actors who would really gel together. And that was really kind of cool insight to get into the process and how it works. But there's nothing like going on the set and actually seeing the way that Harald had the sets built. You know, each one was incredibly detailed, and it was rendered, you know, down to the last little thing. I went into, you know, the library set, and there's all these books, and they've been hand illustrated, and there's the gray book, and each page has a rune, and it's been hand drawn. And I was super happy. I remember Harald, like, wandered onto the library, and I was there, and I was so happy. I, like, ran up and hugged him. He's like, "You're in a good mood." And I was like, "This is so exciting! You have no idea." I was just like, you're transported into the places that you've only imagined, and so there's really nothing like it.
We're gonna get a male perspective. This guy's low in the middle, so just pass the mic back when you get a chance.
A question for Lily. What was one of your funny moments you had during filming?
Oh my gosh. this is pretty funny. You probably wouldn't even be able to tell in the movie. So there's a scene when Jonathan Rhys Meyers, who plays Valentine, is...
In the movie. Can you see it?
In the movie, when you see it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay.
No.
Whatever you. Okay, got it. Okay. Spoiler alert. It's worth it. You'll see it. Right. So there's a scene when I have the cup and I'm threatening to put it in the portal or not, and he comes over and he. You can't hear me? Is this better?
Yes!
Have you not heard anything I've said this whole time? Someone need to press replay? Okay. I'm sure enough of you are tweeting this anyway. Go home and watch it. Okay, so anyway, I have the cup and I'm putting it through the portal and I'm threatening to drop it or not, and he puts his hand in to try to find it, and he insisted on physically having a water bucket to, like, plunge his hand into to feel the water. He wanted to feel the water. And in his close-up, in which you can't really see anything around him anyway, it's just his eyes, he still wanted to do the bucket of water. And I wasn't expecting it, and neither was the man standing there with the bucket like this. Literally, he's standing like this with water, the prop guy. And Jonathan gets so into it, because he's an amazing actor, he's so intense. And he just
puts it in. And I kid you not, I was I was drenching by the end of the shot. Poor guy holding it was drenching. And we weren't even on camera. Like, it was just for the feel of it. So they yell cut, and Jonathan had no idea, and he looks at us. I am just standing there crying with laughter. But I didn't want to ruin his take, so I had to pretend I was crying. Like, I had to pretend that it was, like, so scary that I was, like, crying. And the props guy, he just closed his eyes. Like, he couldn't deal with it. So it was moments like that that you won't even really see in the movie, but just know that behind the scenes we were laughing with.
Okay.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, and one more. The prop guy, bless him, he was the best. He had to deal with so much stuff. You know how I take the cup out of the card? Mm-hmm. Well, we actually had, like, you know, we'll see with special effects and stuff, we had a big card that was cut out, and every time I had to go in to grab it, was like a really intense moment, and I was either crying or, like, frustrated or flustered, and every time I'd go to put my hand in, there's the prop guy, like... He would be like this horrible grin on his face, holding his cup, and every single time I'm like so intense, and you'll see in the movie, it's so crying, and I just go to reach it, and he's just there like, and I was like, how can you do that to me? So every single time, that was life on set.
All right, I'm gonna give this one to the jumping girl, because you've been jumping.